A very good day, all the dear students. So today I would like to take a topic which is coming under unit 3. It's a part of unit 3, the last topic, that is structure and uses of various alkyl halides. Okay, so you are going to learn today's session the structures and uses. So what is this general structure of alkyl halide? Alkyl group means one group will be there, like CH3 or C2H5, any alkyl group will be present, right? Generally we will indicate it with R and halides. So halogen groups will be present, one or more halogens will be present in that particular alkane, which will be replaced with one or more number of hydrogens depending on the number of halogens present in the structure. So let us see what are the compounds available syllabus. So according to PCI syllabus, they have prescribed these compounds under this unit 3, ethyl chloride, chloroform, ethyl iodoform. You have different compounds. Okay, so let us discuss individual compounds now. The first compound is ethyl chloride. So alkyl halide, the alkyl group here is ethyl group. So what is the formula of ethane? It is CH3CH3 or C2H6. When I said while group, ethyl group, that means minus one hydrogen, right? So in the place of hydrogen, when chlorine is attached to the ethane group, it is called chloroethane or also called as ethyl chloride. The molecular formula of ethyl chloride is CH3CH2Cl. Understand? So this is the IUPAC name for ethyl chloride and this is the molecular formula for ethyl chloride. So in according to the syllabus, you need to know just the structure and uses. Okay, so what are different uses of this ethyl chloride? So it is a precursor for making polymers. Precursor means what? It's a starting material. Okay, to polymer. Poly means what? Many molecules will join together to give a bigger molecule. So it's a small molecule. So when small molecules join together, it will form a bigger molecule. So that is why it is called a precursor for formulating polymers. Okay, then the second use is aerosol spray propellant. So aerosols, you know, right? Different sprays, different painkillers are coming in the form of aerosols, right? So there, to release a medicament, they will use some propellant. So this ethyl chloride is also one of the spray propellant. Understand? And the second one is used as a refrigerant. So there are many refrigerating agents, so which will have the cooling capacity to cool or capacity to preserve the particular specimens or chemicals. So in that category, this ethyl chloride also is coming. So it is categorized as refrigerant. So there are main uses only we have to study. So generally these kind of questions comes for 2 marks or 5 marks, they will give 2 compounds. So minimum weightage will be like 2 to 7 marks you will get from this particular presentation or particular session. Today's session is one part of that kind of compounds. Still you have different categories in for the syllabus. Okay, so the main uses of ethyl chloride are used as precursor to make polymers and aerosol spray propellant, and also used as a refrigerant. Okay, so you can see the structure. Ethyl means two carbons are available. So according to ethane, it is C6H6, but ethyl we are saying, so one of the hydrogen is replaced by chlorine group, that is why it is also called as chloroethane. Okay, the next compound, chlorines, that's why it is called as trichloromethane. Coming to the general formula, CHCl3. Okay, this chloroform is generally they are using in the surgeries for as anesthetic agent. Okay, so it's very very important, and also generally we are using this chloroform even in the organic chemistry labs, like for purification purpose, to extract some particular compound from natural drugs and all we will use, right? So another use is solvent. It is used as solvent for fats and iodine value. Okay, and also it is used as a reagent for testing primary amines. So one of the major reagent used to identify the primary amines. Okay, next, production of the refrigerant freons. Same way, it is also used for refrigeration or refrigerant purpose. Okay, called as refrigerant freons. So this is the entire brief explanation about chloroform. You can see the structure already discussed. The next compound, tetrachloro. Since I have told trichloro, three chlorines are there. Suppose tetra means one more chlorine. So four chlorines for the next compound. So tetrachloroethylene. This is another compound. So four chlorines will be there. Since you said it, two carbons are there. Violin double bond is present. So what are the uses of this? Mainly used in dry cleaning. Also excellent solvent for organic materials. So all these alkyl halides are excellent solvents. General use you can remember. And also a solvent used as a solvent to remove grease from the metal part. Same way how trichloroethylene we are using, same way tetrachloroethylene also having the use as removing the grease from metal. Cleaning as dichloro, so that two hydrogens are there. Say tetra, there is no hydrogens, so it is also called as carbon tetrachloride. Common name is carbon tetra. Tetra means four, chloride means Cl. So also called as tetrachloro methane. So you can see here it is a main solvent for IR. IR means infrared spectroscopy. So infrared spectroscopy is nothing but to detect the functional groups, we will use this technique. So for the technique, this is one of the solvent. Also an useful solvent for hallucinations. Okay, hallucination reaction, you know, no, chlorination, bromination. Okay, all those reactions when under this solvent, it will be possible. And used to prepare CFC propellants. CFC means chlorofluorocarbons. Okay, and also refrigerants. And also it's a dry cleaning agent and fire extinguisher. And solvent for various products like rubber, insecticides and soaps. Okay, so these all alkyl halides are having almost generally uses as refrigerants, propellants and various manufacturing of various products like this insecticides, soaps, vitamins, hormones, etc. So in general also you can write all the uses. So mainly used as solvents. And the next one is iodoform. We have already discussed about chloroform. So chloroform means three chlorines are there, trichloromethane it is. Since it is called as iodoform, three iodines will be replaced with the chlorine. Okay, similar structure, only this halogen atom is different. Clear? So the best uses are antiseptic. See, various wounds, various to remove the wound or pus and all that, they will put all bandages and all, no? So that time iodoform is one of the antiseptic agent used in the hospitals. And also disinfectant, so to clean up all the areas, to make them sterile, this is one of the best disinfecting agent. Hope you all understand.